It's a football fans podcast and the people behind CelticUnderground.net wishing you a very Merry Christmas. This is the interviews, the post-game interviews from the Celtic victory over the second best team in Scotland, Aberdeen. It was a tight and equal first half, and the second half Celtic blew them away. Anyway, we've got Kristopher Ajer, Brendan Rodgers, and then two people who are at a different game, Mark Reynolds and Derek McInnes of Aberdeen. Could have got this up earlier because it's only 2 or 3 hours away from the Dundee game, but with the festive period, it's just been too busy. So here is, first up, Kristopher Ajer, followed by the blessed blinded Brendan Rodgers.
Chris, how are you enjoying being back in the side again?
No, it's it feels really good to play games here for Celtic. It's such a fantastic club. Playing in front of 60,000 today, it's unbelievable.
What's the manager said to you about, you know, putting you back in?
No, he believes in his whole squad, and everyone is working so hard in training every single day, so when we get our chance, we are ready. So he believes in everyone, he believes in me, and that's a really good feeling when you come in.
You're playing regularly for Kilmarnock when you're out on loan. How was it when you had to sit out when you came back?
No, to be fair, Celtic is a massive club and there's so many good players there, and they're performing well in every game. So it's, you know, just to train hard every single day and be fit, and when you get your chance, you have to take it.
Can you sense you're improving under the manager?
Sorry?
Can you sense that you're improving?
Yeah, since this year, 2017, has been my best year in terms of improvement. When I came here, I was a young boy, and now I feel like I'm coping well with how the gaffer wants to play and how the team's operating.
With all these busy festive fixtures, are you feeling that you're beginning to build up momentum again after beat to Hearts?
Yeah, we obviously we had 2 months back against Sporting, and I think we did well there, and today we beat Aberdeen, which is a really good team, 3-0, so we're really bounced back here.
With Aberdeen in second place, will that give you more confidence going into the game on Boxing Day that you're able to beat the team so comfortably even over second in the league?
Today we performed really good. That's that we see in the result, and Aberdeen did a great job in the beginning of the game. We were under real pressure in the beginning, so it was a tough game, and now we're looking forward to Dundee as well.
Brendan, your thoughts after 3-0?
Well, very... very convincing win, I felt. First half, we, you know, it was a battle, which you'd expect. You know, Aberdeen with a clean week to prepare for the game, so coming and using the physicality in the game, which is great. You know, they're a good side, and they showed that, you know, over the course of the last performance. So we knew it was going to be that type of game. Second half, we just said that at half time, just, you know, you need to win that battle, and you need to be physical, of course, but you also need to find the calmness to play football, or else it just becomes a fight. And this is a team that can do that, but they have to be able to play football. And I thought second half they were outstanding, you know, in the position, and allowed us to have greater and longer periods with the ball, pressing higher up the field, and then allowed us to then create more opportunities. So it was a very, very good win. Clean sheet for us, and some of our players that came into the team today were outstanding.
Johnny Hayes, you brought him back in and you got his goal as well. Your thoughts
on this performance? Delighted. Young Irishman, you know what it means to be from Ireland and support, and but to play for Celtic and get your first goal for Celtic, especially against your old club, it's a really special day for him. He's just settling into the club, but the last couple of months really seen him then make a step forward and in training just being that bit more direct. Sometimes you come into a new club, you're a little bit safe and you be everyone's friend, you know, but now he's really aggressive in his game, both with and without the ball, and you've seen him today, he was absolutely brilliant. If you track where he's run from the goal, that hunger and ambition to get in the box to get the finish was great. So delighted for him.
Is it just been a question of time, Johnny?
Yeah, time, but it's also respecting the teams and the squad that he was coming into. I think there's that initial period when you come into Celtic. You know, it's a huge club, big expectancy, and where you have to be at your very best on a daily basis. And that there for some is tough. But he's a great lad. The players love him. You know, he's really settled into the squad. Just there was no pressure on him. I didn't need him to find his top form straight away, because we've got other great wingers here. But he's a player for our squad that can play in a number of positions, and like you see today, his threat with his speed, his power, his direct running ability, and his work rate, which is very, very important.
Ajer was very assured for a boy of his age.
Yeah, I thought he was brilliant. I said afterwards in the changing room, you know, to all the players, you know, this is a boy last year when I came in, 18 years of age, 6'5", but just needed sort of some men's football. We sent him to Kilmarnock, and he was taught very well there with Lee, and both Lees when he was there. And I found when he came back then in the summer, he was a man. You know, he's physically developed, played in some of the Champions League games early on, done very, very well. So again, it's time, but at 6'5", he's fast, can carry the ball, and you see now he wins his aerial challenges as well. So he's a big prospect for us, and he was very good.
Spoke about real confidence. I mean, he's going to be bringing the ball out.
We have to. You play for a club like Celtic, and how in particular I want the players to play, you have to have comfort on the ball. He's got this great quality where he steps in and he covers the ground very, very quickly. You know, he just eliminates people when he goes in. And especially you play against teams if they're sat in a block where it's low, you need at least one of your central defenders to be able to carry the ball, and that commits and opens up the space. So yeah, his decision making is getting better all the time, and again, part of a team that's kept another clean sheet.
You must be happy you're closer to that 10-point gap you were hoping for at the turn of the year.
Well, no, listen, I'm not going to lose sleep over it, you know, but it was just something that we talked about over the course of, you know, setting ourselves some 6-week small goals, really. But if it's 9 or 8, I'm not going to cry, you know. It was a very, very good win on the back of a good victory for us during the week. And like you say, it's something that we want to do now over these next couple of games. Well, it wasn't the back, it was the team. You know, collectively as a team, we weren't at the level. But most important, like I say, after disappointment, you can learn. And we've now come into, you know, the next 2 games, scored 5 goals, kept a clean sheet. And I think what was really impressive today was our physicality in the game. And you think of the number of games that we've played as a squad, and you think of the game in midweek, you know, which is taxing physically and mentally, to then come out to play against a team that are off the back of one of the best performances against Hibs, and like I say, a full week to prepare to put that level of performance in was very impressive, I feel, as a team.
Sorry, Brent,
sorry,
I didn't mean to interrupt. Did you have any hesitation about putting
Ajer
into the old firm game on Saturday, based on how
what's off on you? No, it doesn't matter for me what age someone is. It's just picking the best team each game to get the result. So, I would have no hesitation. Like I say, he's got all the qualities. It's just about getting him experience.
Suppose the message to the players looking at Dundee and Rangers is that intensity you've seen in the second half to make sure that's maintained, even though it's only the year, right until the end of the year?
Not really. Our messages are very simple. You know, we're in a real tough schedule of games, and our focus is only the next game. You know, you see the players are working hard out on the pitch. Now the ones that haven't been playing, they'll be ready. We'll be in Christmas Day training. We'll travel to Dundee, and then we'll pick a team to put that intensity and that level into the game, and then look to hopefully get 3 points there, and then only then will we think about the Rangers game.
Okay. Disappointing afternoon.
No, hugely disappointing. I think that's probably the overwhelming feeling just now. We put so much into it, we worked so hard off the ball, thought we were good going forward, I thought we controlled parts of the game, but we've come here and ultimately 2 deflections and a bad back pass from Kenny Plains cost us. But that happens against Celtic if you give them chances and look pressing, they score goals. But no, I think we can come away from this and take a lot of positives. So no, it was some good performances, good individual performances, and some good passages of play. But I just hugely disappointed with the result.
Seemed to dominate second half a bit. You really pressed them in the first half, but sort of sat back? Was it intentional, or was it just legs at that point?
It wasn't really intentional. I think it was just the way the kind of flow of the game. I think, you know, we had a lot of energy, kind of high press in the first half, and then we lose the goal, and it's obviously going to deflate you a bit. And then I think, like you say, we come out the second half, and I don't think probably we started the way we wanted. We kind of let them on the ascendancy and pin us in, but I thought we were still taking the ball, we were still going out and creating chances, and then we lose the second one, and I think it's one of the goals that just saps you. I think if we'd scored to make it one each, then we'd get a huge lift and it'd be a different game. But when I think that second one goes in, and you've worked so hard, you start feeling it, and boys start dropping, and you start to really, it's an uphill battle. And then again, when the third goes in, it just compounds it. So no, it's a hard one to take.
When you get so many chances, especially a place like this, you do really got to take them, or you're going to be punished for it.
No, exactly. I think if we take our chances, or if we can get it back to one each, and it's a completely different game. And as I say, I thought we played well for large parts of it, but you come here and you don't get the break of the ball, and that's what can happen.
Is that second goal, you thinking the header, you're putting it out for a corner?
It's just one of the ones that's come in late. Arnie's tracking back, and he's not going to get a toe on it, and it's rightly so, he leaves it, and it's just a last minute header, and as you say, it's out for a corner, like 99 times 100, but hits off him, and it couldn't have fell any perfect for him to slot in, and it just kind of almost killed the game for us a wee bit.
It's the eighth in a row defeat to Celtic, Mark. Is it
playing
your mind at all?
I don't think so. I mean, I think you see the performance out there, it's not as if we've came here and they battered us, or we can't compete with them. And I think we've played well, as I say, for large parts, and I think if you reverse the roles, if we get that wee bit of luck, if we get that deflection or that break, or if we hit a shot and it loops off somebody's shoulder and goes in, then it's a different game. And it's hard to account for that. I don't think you can't practice that in training, and you certainly can't manage it or tell players, right, this is what we're going to do. So no, I think we've went out and we feel good about our performance. Ultimately we've lost 3-0, but as I say, if the luck had been flipped and we get that wee deflection, then it could be a completely different story.
Does it feel like your luck as well, when it's Johnny that's there to pouncing the ball when it breaks?
A wee bit, aye. It's obviously disappointing, and last season he was doing that for us, but that's football, isn't it?
So that 3-0 feel different from the one at Pittodrie?
I think so. I think we acquitted ourselves a lot better than that one. I think we came out and we gave a good showing, and as I say, there's large parts of the game where we can take a lot of positives from, and it's one of the ones where we're lucky at Christmas, you don't really get a chance to dwell on it, and there's games coming thick and fast, and we move on to the next game now and concentrate on getting 6 points in the next two games and setting us nice up for the break.
Thanks, Mark.
Cheers, guys.
Thanks.
Have
a good Christmas.
Is it disappointment or frustration more, the result?
Yeah, I think there's always disappointment when you prepare to get a result, and we came here believing we can get a result, and I think there was a lot of good, especially in that first half performance. You know, we didn't have our troubles to seek. You know, last night, you know, Shea Logan ruled out, never travelled with a bug. Stevie May ruled out yesterday morning. It's just the kind of onset of the tackle in the Rangers game. He's been having problems with it, and it's flared up, and we need to deal with that. We then had to deal with Scott McKenna this morning, having a tightness in his calf, and in consultation with medical people, we felt this was a game. If he missed this one, he could play in the next two, so rather than aggravating it, you know, Christie's already unable to play. So there's four there that's been part of a winning team, ruled out right away. So we had adjustments to make, and I thought the players who came in, who haven't had a lot of game time, did particularly well in that first half. So it was a bit makeshift, but there was still a semblance of authority in our game, I thought, in the first half. I thought we made contact, we pressed well in good areas, we looked after the ball, we got into good areas. The only criticism I was going to have of the team at half time was the fact that we never made more of our opportunities. We got into good areas, and we were guilty of not working a goalkeeper enough and having that real conviction about our play. So, and I think they got a huge slice of luck, Celtic. I didn't think there was a lot in the game. You know, there wasn't any. I mean, the referee's actually in the eye line of Joe Lewis when Lustig takes a shot. It comes off Dominic Ball and it totally diverts the ball in another direction, which can happen. But I do think it's a really untidy slapdash goal to separate teams. And I thought if we got to half time 0-0, it would be the emphasis on my talk would be to try and make sure there's that more conviction in the first half. And I think the Celtic players come off to a better reception, maybe what they could have got, because I thought we were a better team first half. And then I think the second half, I thought Celtic started better, although they never really opened us up too much. I was looking for us to carry more of a threat again, but second goal was a wee bit. We've had 3 assists today for them. You know, it's they get to the byline, which can happen. And Reynolds' header comes off of Anderson and it falls to Johnny Hayes, and it's 2-0. And I do think it was an untidy goal rather than any real quality from the opposition, which they're capable of. And then I think that knocked the stuffing out of us, and that can happen here. You know, I thought the players were very brave and very committed. The consequence of me having 4 or 5 injuries means it affects my bench. You know, didn't really have a lot of real options to come in and try and influence tactically anything. It was light for light at centre forward, so we had to really go as we were. We picked up a little knock with Shinney second half as well, and he wasn't as effective as he was first half. As a consequence, and the third goal that Kenny makes a mistake, and I thought he was excellent as well, and it was unfortunate for us and him. But at 3-0, I thought Celtic then started to enjoy the game, and we were we had the knock to stuffing at us, and it was a tough last 20 minute watch for us. But I'm not going to dwell on it. I'm going to take the positives for the game, because we're on a positive run, and there's still a lot of positives to take from the performance, especially when you take into consideration injuries.
Yeah, quite yourselves. Would you say far better than the game at
Pittodrie earlier? Yeah. I thought in the previous game, I thought Celtic were very good, and when Celtic are very good and on it, they can cause any team's problems. I thought the two teams were very close today. I must admit that. And yes, goals change games, and we're guilty of not getting ourselves in front when we had opportunities. But even the second half, and when Arneson is free at the front post, and Nicky Maynard's get a free header, we've had one or two other opportunities, we've had an opportunity to work the goalkeeper, so we're no without blame, and it's not just down to luck we've lost the game. But I do think that there was a touch of fortune about at least a couple of Celtic's goals.
Before you mentioned at the start, they're back for the next game.
Logan will be alright, May won't be, Christy obviously will be, McKenna, we're hoping, should be, calling him a physio, and if he's wrong, then he'll be at an overhang. It'll be a few weeks, I think. We need to, it was a bad challenge at the time, and we were really concerned about it. We got it scanned, and it's just, he's tried to work through it. His training's been monitored and a bit different from everybody else's to try and get him ready for games, but he's... You know, he tried to train Thursday, and he came in yesterday morning, and the ankle had blown right up again. And there's work needing done to that. I'm not being no surgery, but there's certainly some treatment needing and some rest in that area, because it's just been getting worse and worse from that challenge. So we need to go as we are now for the next couple of games, and then hopefully, as I say, we can finish 2017 off positively. I'm pleased with what the players have given me this calendar year. And if we can go and win our next two home games, you know, I think we'd be quite pleased with our work for this period. And then we can rest down, do what we need to do in January if we can, and look forward to the second part of the campaign.
Lustig seemed to make a point coming over and celebrating in front of your dugout when he scored. Was there anything in that?
I never noticed that.
That's now, I think, 8 losses in a row to Celtic. How frustrating is that for you?
Cheers for that. Yeah, very. You know, I think there's been some closer than others, and I think today was close up to a point. Without making too many excuses, the vast difference in resource always makes them ahead of us. You know, I've said this often enough. We've got one of their players who's arguably my best player this season, and they probably took my best player for last season, who's been playing a cameo up until today. So there is a huge gulf there in terms of what they can do and what we can do, but I still feel there's a result in us, and I'll keep saying that and keep believing we can beat them. I do think the game was closer than the result suggests. Anybody that wasn't here today would think it was just normal practice, and I think up until 60, 65 minutes it was a different type of game. Thank you.
Okay. Cheers.
Bring me sunshine in your smile, bring me laughter all the while. In this world where we live, there should be more happiness. So much joy you can give to each brand new bright tomorrow. Make me happy through the years, never bring me any tears. Let your arms be as warm as the sun from up above. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring me love. sunshine in your smile. Bring me laughter all the while. In this world where we live, there should be more happiness. So much joy you can give to each brand new bright tomorrow. Make me happy through the years. Never bring me any tears. Let your arms be as warm as the sun from up above. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring me love, sweet love. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine.